Okay, so in this video, I wanted to show you how to build and mount the automated Z-bed that I designed. These are all the pieces that you need. So these are the pieces for the lower part of the bed, the upper part, motor and motor mounts, and corner screws that make the bed go up and down. So, starting with the motor mount first, because then those have all those pieces here, so I can get them out of the way. So, starting with the motor, it's a stepper motor that I salvaged from an old 3D printer. It already has the tooth pulley on here, so I just left it on. It's just perfect for what I needed it for. Just get two screws. Two is enough. Doesn't need to be on there much tighter. No need to tighten the screws too much. Just need to be held there. That's enough. Okay, so now we have this part. It goes on like this. It's in two parts because for printing purposes, if you would print it as a single part, you need lots of support to be able to print it, and that's drag. So I decided to split it into two, and the screws that will finally fasten it to the bed are also used to hold the two pieces together. So if you have this, this is how it will go, and then the belt that we have here will come in here, go around the pulley and go out again. And to make sure that they are aligned properly, we use these guide wheels here as well. So the belt will go around nicely. So let's mount those. We'll get a nut, put it in here, get the screw, and screw it on. You can do this manually, there's no need, especially because what you want is to just, when you tighten it and then go slightly back so this booty turns very nicely without too much resistance. As well. Now it could be that because it's not very tight, so that after some time perhaps the nut would get undone, it could fall out, perhaps. I haven't been using it in long enough to know if that could happen, but maybe then it would need some Loctite to make sure that they stay there. And this one goes in here, clicks in here, like this. And this is the final mounted piece. I will set it aside for now because later on I will mount it on the bed itself. So now we go on with the lower part of the bed, the one that will actually be screwed to the laser cutter itself, to the bottom plate of the laser cutter itself. So we have these aluminum tubes, square tubes, and we have these corner parts. These corner parts have these bearings from skates, like rollerblades. They're completely normal ones, you can buy them everywhere, and they fit right in. I've already put them in here because I actually use a little bit of super glue to stick them to it, just a very little bit, so they stick them there, because they tended to fall out. The piece is not really tight enough. I could have printed others, but I just decided to leave it like this. So they are in here. But just enough to make them stay, and it should be very easy to just pull them out again if I really needed to. But in these pieces, they're symmetrical, so it doesn't matter which way you put it in. Just remember the sardisa for the bottom ones. So now we will go and mount them. So these go in here. You just push, that's it. Take the other one. Push, and that's it. Take this one. This one, and that's it. Now, very important, don't try to put this one here and then try putting that one in, because that means that you'll have to twist to make things work, and it'll probably break things or bend things, and that's not what you want. So what you do is you take the other two pieces and you first put them in here, and then gently you put them in and push together so they will go in without too much twisting. So that's it. That's the basic part of the lower bed. I've already made some holes in here for mounting it on the bottom plate of the laser cutter. I haven't made the holes on the laser cutter yet. That's for another video. But I've made those holes here. These are perhaps, it seems like in weird places, but first of all, I just wanted three holes. With four, you get the possibility of twisting, and you have to be really careful that you're not twisting the entire frame out of alignment. So this is just, so if I wanted to be able to level it, then I can do that with three. And these are in more to the side, because the belt will run just off the center of these tubes. So in that case, I decided to put them more to the side. So now, the next part is, well, first we will mount the top part of the bed. So let's put this one away. Get these parts. These were basically the same way as the other one. The only thing that to remind to be careful here is that these are not symmetrical parts. So these parts actually have a top part and a bottom part. The bottom part has this hole, which is for fitting the nuts that are on the corner screws, which is actually what will make the bed go up and down. So be careful that you have them all in the same alignment. And then the last one is again with the same trick we used before. Don't put any here. You first need to put them on this end. This one is really tight. Might take a moment. Looks better. Okay, again, make sure that they are all in the right alignment, and then come in on both sides and push. Okay, well, that's our top part. We will now get back to the bottom part, because now we'll start mounting the corner screws, which is really easy. In another video, I will show how to make these, but this is very simple. You just put it in there, and that's it. They're very easy to put in and to pull out, and that's on purpose, because the bed completely mounted cannot be fitted into the laser cutter. It does fit, of course, but you cannot put it in well mounted, so you there's just not enough room. So you have to put it in there unmounted, first at the bottom and then the corner screws and the rest, and so it has to be very easy to take apart, otherwise you wouldn't be able to do that. Okay, so these are all here. And what we do now as well is mount the motor, which has some slots here, especially made for the nuts. That's one. And that's two. Now we get the screws. Feeling around to make it to the other side. That's one. And the other. Now, I'll try to make sure these nuts don't fall out well. Screw these on. Don't try to fasten these all at once, first one and then the other, because again that might twist and break things. Just give them a couple of turns on one side and then again on the other side. And again, like the other pieces, it doesn't really, you don't really have to tighten them very much. It's like it's enough. The moment you feel resistance, you get a little bit more, and that's it. Okay, so now what you can do is put the belt on. Get the belt, this 1.5 meter belt, this one. It's like 152 to be more exact. You just get it like this, teeth on the inside, you make a loop, you put it in here. You make sure that it goes around the pulley of the motor, and then you get one side on one side of the belt. You do it to one end and then the other, and like this. Then you go around this corner screw, making sure it's in the teeth pulley, and around this one. Last one. And then yes. Well, as you can see, there's way too much slack. So but that's what we have these parts for. So we have this guide and this part. And we just put them together with the screw. You can do this by hand, it's just more than enough. It doesn't need to be tight at all. It's just there to make sure it doesn't fall out. Okay. Now we have this, and as you can see, there is a hole here, and you might not be able to see that very well, but there's a hole here as well, and that's meant that you can have some string, a fishing line, whatever that you could put through there to tension the belt, which is what we will do last. We won't do this yet, but as you can see here right now, if you turn one of these, all of them turn, so that works perfectly. Now we can put this on the top, and like I said, you have to make sure that you use this side down, this side where the holes here for the nuts are. You just turn them until they drop in. Might not be completely level right now because we've been turning these around. So it's very easy to make them level. So, and then I have cut this sheet that I bought somewhere, and I just cut it to the right size, and I cut these holes in there. I didn't cut holes in there to make it fit on there and stay there. I made them like this, so it's very easy, while this is inside this laser cutter, to just put the sheet on and take it off again. Okay, this is it. I don't know, I forgot. There's also the end stop for the bed. Just simply clicks on there, you plug it in, and it should work. It's specifically made for a printed part, specifically for this setup. If you would have a different motor with a different height or whatever, then that piece would have to be changed. But for this setup, with this particular motor, that height is the perfect height, that if you go down and it activates, it's like 1 millimeter above of the motor. So it uses the most amount of travel that this setup allows. With this motor on the inside, of course, we are limited. You cannot go very much down. Perhaps in the future I will make a new design, putting the motor on the outside. But that really makes the design a little bit different, because the motor cannot be, first of all, it had to be here because it needs to be on the other side of the laser cutter where there is some room. There's just no room on these sides without making holes in the frame of the laser cutter, and I don't want to do that. But here there is room, but it's further away, so I would need to make some kind of extension, put the motor more to the left, and just a different kind of design. I decided to go with this one first, and if I'm really happy with it, but I'm not happy with the amount of travel the bed has, then I can also always make changes. But honestly, I think I'll be just cutting things that are maybe up to a centimeter thick. It won't do much more than that. Engraving perhaps thicker things, yeah, it could be useful for that, but I haven't been doing that yet, so that's why I say I can always keep that for a future extension. Anyway, this was the entire explanation, and I'll make a new video when I'm ready to put it inside the laser cutter. Okay, thank you.